Are you excited to go on your bike trip?
Yep. There we are, all set to start the show. How are you feeling, Patrick?
Amazing.
You look amazing. There's good old Pat. Pat's pedal fell off in the middle of the road and took us a while to get it back on because we're steering it the wrong way.
My pedal fell off while I was biking. I tried to screw it back on and stripped all the threads, and there was a moment where Jeff and I thought I was going to have to pedal with one pedal for the next 400 miles.
So we're in good shape. Tomorrow is the coast. Morning. It's the start of day two, and we're just getting up. It's like 6:15 in the morning. Just gonna have some breakfast, pack up the camp, and see what day two brings us.
This is gonna be the least sweaty I am for the next 12 hours.
Almost heaven, West Virginia, West Virginia.
I thought we were there almost.
You think so?
How do you feel about biking another 15K, Pat?
Static. I have nothing to say.
We're on Highway 101. We're at the coast.
West Virginia.
So Jeff, day three.
Yeah.
This one is particularly fat. Too much water in. No, actually, it's starting to absorb. Not so bad. Fresh cherries.
Butt feel?
Less than amazing.
This is,
what was it called again?
I don't know.
Burn something? Or?
Oh, boiler point?
And I clipped one of my feet, and instead of leaning to the direction that I had one foot on clips, I leaned to the direction where I had a foot clip and bails and hit my hands, which are actually pretty okay. Mostly just bone and sock tissue damage. Luckily my skin is intact. Jeff also crashed into a bush.
Day four, Pat.
Day four. Jeff, well, he's unconscious, farts an exceptional amount. Yeah, luckily, I'm contained in the same tent as him. My hand feels okay from my crash. It only hurts when I grab onto things like handles. I was changing in the bathroom of a pirate-themed Pizza Hut. And I put my wallet on like a ledge on the side of the bathroom and then finished changing and walked out without it. And then we had dinner and cycled 20 kilometers. And I realized when we went to go pay for camping that I had no wallet. The guy overheard our conversation and offered to give me a ride, which was super nice of him. He was a retired, well, not soon to be retired, Marine Corps logger, trucker. That had some interesting stories about gasoline. So
June 6th.
214 miles to go.
I'm pretty much done. And caused a very superficial wound.
Well, superficial wound for a superficial person.
Also, we camped next to what I think was either a hillbilly Sean Penn or Sean Penn researching the role for a hillbilly. He smoked how many joints?
82.
82 joints in his tent. Which, and he actually had quite a nice sleeping pad. It was actually just a mountain of McDonald's burger cartons that he laid out.
Jeff is about to go sit by the road to charge the thing that's recording me currently. I'm gonna set an alarm for 1 hour and 30 minutes. It's my Jeff is dead alarm. And if it goes off and Jeff's not back, Jeff's dead.
Old lady's pleasant and demure, a sallow cheeked and sure. I can see your chony. And all the boys you drag about, an empty fellow bound from Saturdays to Monday.
Yeah, we just finished dinner. We bought all the ingredients for the sandwich and ate them separately. I spread Nutella directly into my mouth. Yeah, now we're just relaxing. Jeff is about to go take his 25th shower of the trip. We did the Seven Devils Road, which we found out later, each devil is a large hill that you have to go up and then somewhat down. We went to Walmart.
We cycled furiously. Set up camp.
I attached a banana to the back of my bike and biked about a half a kilometer and it fell off without me noticing. And Jeff almost crashed again multiple times.
He almost got hit by a truck on the
bridge. Oh yeah, that was scary.
Yeah, that's about all we did today.
Oh, we ate McDonald's for breakfast.
Almost 6 minutes of rambling.
Sweet. Can you cut that down to like 6 seconds? That'd be great.
Yeah.
This is the realest thing, as ancient choirs sing, a dozen blushing cherubs wild above Los Angeles, my love.
Today was supposed to be the easy 30 mile day. Instead, it was the nightmare 30 mile day. Sat on like a jersey barrier and it was actually pretty comfortable. Then I walked around the jersey barrier and someone left a bag of poop.
Some Cliff Bars. Because Patrick ran out.
Okay. Jeff has eaten all of his as well.
No. Raccoons ate all of them.
Yeah, but if the raccoons hadn't gotten to them, you would have gotten to them.
Yes, that's true.
Tomorrow's gonna be the hopefully easy 50 mile day. Jeff and I are going to do one shot for every mile we've done, according to Jeff. So it's roughly 370 shots of alcohol.
Today was a pleasant day, and you just want to keep going, you know? It could take a rest day tomorrow, and then the next day after, I could always just keep going.
10 more miles to go. Reached astronomical heights. Astronomical ass pain.
Hooray.
Hooray! We
We took a necessary detour to the California sign.
Battery exhausted.
Yeah, well, guess I'm also.
Here we are at Ray's Food Palace. Ray's Food Palace waiting to go take the shuttle to Medford and then shuttle bus back to Portland today.
Wish we could keep going to San Francisco, but we can't.
Hey Pat.
Yeah,
go. How do you feel?
Great. We're closing in on hour 24 of our bus trip, which is roughly a 6-hour drive by car. Pretty excited to be home soon. Also, I have another 6 hours to drive by car.
Great.
Yeah.